Today we're going to talk about switch mode power supplies, and specifically we'll talk about the use of the inductor in the switch mode power supply. And of course the key to one of these converters is what, Valerie? Right, the inductor. So first we need to start with just the basics. So we're just going to talk about an inductor. Here we have a basic inductor and our equation, which you should have memorized, V equals L dI/dt. This is our governing equation for an inductor. And we memorize this, we know what this looks like, but we have to make sure that we define our polarity, right, the positive and negative, and also the direction of the current. So here, we're going to call this IL, so the current through the inductor, and then VL will be the polarity. And we're gonna make this positive and make this negative, so this is gonna be our VL. Okay, so let's take this idea now and we'll put it into a switch mode. So here's an example. This is the basic structure for a buck converter. And here we have an inductor, our inductor L. And what we're doing is we're connecting the input, we're switching it between these two states. And so we're switching it from between some voltage, V in, and then in this case, we're switching it between that voltage and ground. So what we have to do to analyze this circuit is look at both cases. So when you have a switching circuit, you have to figure out how many cases you have and then model each of those independently. That's the switching part of the switch mode power supply. So here's our switch. So we want to look at two different cases. So first, let's look at when we have our current here. So here, the voltage across this inductor, and again, let's label the same polarities and the same current here, would be Vin minus Vout. And in this case, we're just using idealized voltage sources, so our VL here would be exactly that. So we'd have VI minus Vout equals L, and then DIL DT. Okay, so that's our basic equation. Now let's look at the other case when the switch is not in that direction, but it is connected here. In this case, we're connected to ground. I'll just draw a ground for clarity. And we can write these equations again. So this would be, we're gonna say stage one for now, S1, and stage two. And here we have the voltage now is zero minus V out, right? Because of the polarity, this side minus that side. So we have negative V out equals L di t dt. So here is our basic equation for these two sides. All we're doing, as you can see, is changing the voltage across this inductor. We're going to talk about how the current looks as it's going through the inductor. So what we want to draw is a graph over time of the IL, current through the inductor, over time. So we're going to do our two states real quick. We're going to look at these equations and we're going to break it down a little bit. So here we want to look at the change in the current, and what we can do is let's try to just solve the equation for IL. First we'll do stage one in purple. So we have this equation. Let's now just look for IL. To solve for IL, we need to take the integral and we need to move this L over. So if we rewrite that, we're going to just go IL, oops, no dt, it's equal to VI minus V out, right? And then we do move the L over, divided by L, and then we can take the integral of all that, so dt here. And then we'll get our equation for IL. And this is over time. So this is during stage one, that's what we're gonna get. Stage one. And during stage two, we are going to do the same thing. The only thing that's different here is this negative, right? So essentially we're making V in zero. So it's the same equation, stage two, IL of T is equal to the integral of negative V out over L dt. Here, so if we integrate, this is a constant. We can take that out, it's in dt. So we just get We're going to get VI minus V out over L, and then just over time. Okay? And then for our stage two, we're going to get IL T, this time just negative V out over L times T. These are our two equations, again, S1 and S2, stage one and stage two. Let's just draw that on over time. So we're going to call this stage, say this is S1, and let's say that we start here. We're at some value. Then we see that this is going to increase over time at this constant rate. So it's actually just going to be a linear line, and our angle here is going to be VI minus V out over L. So that's our angle. And then once we hit this point and we switch from being connected here to being connected here, then we will start to go by this equation, which is the same except for the polarity is going to be negative this time, and it's going to just go linearly downwards with time. So let's say S2 is during this period, stage 2. And you'd have to actually calculate it out, but you'll get some negative value according to, the slope of this line will be this negative value. And if you continue to switch between these two, you will continue in the same fashion. So from here to here, and then back down. So this would be stage two and stage one again. This is the basic current waveform that you'll get through the inductor. And this is the most important waveform in a DC-DC converter, and in my opinion, the most beautiful waveform. This is steady state, meaning that the average values are not changing. And this average current, if you'll notice, is positive, and it does not touch zero. When the lowest current and steady state does not touch zero, this is called continuous conduction mode. Continuous conduction mode. And for short, we usually just say CCM. Okay, CCM, this is your normal mode. You usually want to operate in this mode. It's the easiest to understand. And because this average value is in one direction, you can think of this current, the current through the inductor. It can be thought of as effectively an average current source. So it's not exactly the same, but the average current will be going in one direction. And we'll have this kind of waveform. This is called continuous conduction mode. If the average waveform is shifted down, so say, for comparison, we have exactly, it goes exactly to zero, then up, down, exactly hitting zero, but not going below that. That is called boundary mode, or critical conduction mode. Conduction mode. So sometimes people use, but it's also CCM when you say critical. So some people use boundary mode, so it's BCM. Both mean the same thing. It's right on the boundary of going into the next mode. The last mode is called discontinuous conduction mode, and that's when you have some value. The current actually goes to zero and will stay at zero during some of the portion of the waveform. So it'll go up during the positive part, but then hit zero, and you'll have this zero domain. This is called discontinuous conduction mode. Discontinuous conduction mode. The discontinuous part comes from the fact that it goes to zero and it's no longer continuously positive in one direction. So in short, the inductor is the most important component of a switch mode power supply, and you'll want to be aware of if the inductor is in continuous conduction mode or boundary or discontinuous conduction mode.